Hello, my beautiful water signs, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Welcome to your element reading. This is the Dream Clairvoyant. So if you have Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio in your sun, moon, Venus, or rising, this message may resonate with you, but I do ask that you use discernment. Only take what resonates and leave what does not. If you believe that this message isn't for you, you're always welcome to check out the other readings here on the channel, okay? So let's see, let's get started. Okay, Prince of Swords. So also remember that the cards really represent energies that any gender can embody unless I specify it. So this Prince of Swords here, this is a masculine energy, but it could be embodied by a female, okay? So the Prince of Swords, this is someone who is, you know, like the younger version of a King of Swords, excuse me. Prince of Swords is very similar to the King of Swords. This is just someone who may be young in age, in spirit, maybe just very energetic and youthful. But this is someone who is of law and order, you know, very sharp, very strategic, very intelligent, does have the ability to be quite cold and detached when deemed necessary. Prince of Swords is like a very serious, stoic kind of person. Clarify the Prince of Swords. Nine of Swords. Yeah. So the Nine of Swords is when you're just stuck in your head. I think the reason why this person is even being represented by the Prince of Swords is because they've been doing a lot of thinking. They've been up in their head a lot, especially with this Nine of Swords. Nine of Swords is when you're having like sleepless nights, maybe even being haunted, tormented, reminded of something quite unpleasant, being so much in distress that you think that the worst has happened when really the worst has yet to come, you know? So someone's mental health isn't the best. This could be you or someone who you're connected to. Tell us more. Yeah, someone is heavily thinking about the past. The Six of Cups is all about the past, reminiscing about the past, wanting to reconnect with the past, wanting some sort of reunion with the past. With the ten, oh, this person's worried about someone from the past. The Ten of Swords is a betrayal. The ultimate betrayal. It's a big backstab. Tell us more about the situation, Holy Spirit. Thank you so much for guiding us. You have the Justice. So the Justice card. Justice card. This is all about balance, fairness. Queen of Swords. I just keep on feeling like someone's worried about someone from the past. Queen of Swords, this is someone who is very intelligent, clever, witty, discerning, you know, much more logical than emotional. I think it looks here, whoever this person is, this Prince of Swords, whether it's you, water sign, or it's someone who you're connected to, but they're worried. Someone here is worried about another person from the past who is a Queen of Swords. So perhaps the two of them aren't really seeing eye to eye right now. Queen of Swords is very independent. And the Justice card is here. They did something unfair. I feel like they did something unfair to the Queen of Swords, but I don't feel like it was successful because the Justice card is in the upright. So whatever they did, it didn't affect this person as much at all or as much. Let me see. Oh, it didn't. Two of Wands. Two of Wands is like trying to make a decision, trying to, you know, get an overview of everything, trying to get a sense of direction. What did this person... Prince of Cups. I feel Holy Spirit, Prince of Pentacles. Princess of Pentacles is here. It was something. Wow, this person did something. Prince Prince of Swords did something to a Princess of Pentacles, or they did something to someone who is from their past. So they were unable to let this person go and to just move on. Whatever they did to this person, it was to get this person to go back to them. It was to get this person to like focus, to refocus back on them. Because the Two of Wands is trying to get a sense of direction. I further clarified, this is between two people. One is a Prince of Cups and a Princess of Pentacles. One is in this Princess of Pentacles energy. They may be very successful, hardworking, grounded, a very valuable, loyal, committed person. And this Prince is coming out as a Prince of Cups. So they are romantically interested. They have some sort of emotional interest in this Princess of Pentacles. So that's the history. What I'm hearing from Spirit is that's the history between the two of them. When the two of them first met each other, one was a Prince of Cups, one was a Princess of Pentacles. One was very balanced, stable. The other was very emotional. Now, fast forward to now, one is a Prince of Swords, the other is a Queen of Swords. Fast forward to now, clearly one of them has matured. Because one of them went from a princess to a queen, but one of them is now very discerning. Maybe even, you know, Queen of Swords is like a no-nonsense type of person. Very logical, very intelligent, but they do have the ability to put aside their feelings and emotions to make the best decision for themselves. The fact that one is a Prince of Swords, Queen of Swords, I don't feel like they're seeing eye to eye right now. Masculine energy did something here that they regret. Five of cups. What did they see? They did something. This person plays around with mental. This person is into some sort of illusion making. I don't know if this is a mental magic, mental spells. They do something with illusions. I think it went wrong. Trying to get this feminine to think about him. I'm saying him because it's a prince, but remember, these are energies any gender can embody. It's almost like they wanted this woman, this feminine energy to like focus back on them, but it was something with mental because the Four of Swords is contemplation, being heavily in your head. They regret doing that though. I think they're worried that they could have hurt this person by trying to do this work on them. I don't feel like their intention was to hurt this person, but they were desperate. They try to put this person in a Five of Pentacles. Wow, look what's behind the Five of Pentacles, Five of Swords. They try to put this person in a Five of Pentacles, which is, Five of Pentacles is feeling like your life is in despair. Feeling challenged, experiencing back-to-back difficulties, being depressed, being unable to move forward. They try to encage this feminine energy. Five of Swords is defeat. They wanted this feminine energy to feel defeated. Perhaps so that they wouldn't move forward from them. But they're worried that this could have hurt this person. They're regretful now. They're concerned now. this is someone who did some sort of work on someone, and now, yeah, oh, look at this, the High Priestess and the Ten of Swords. They did this to a High Priestess. So, or maybe they're the High Priestess even, because I feel like this is spiritual work. Clarify the High Priestess. Four of Cups, rejection. They're, clarify the High Priestess. They are the High Priestess. And there's judgment on them for this. Mm-hmm. They may think that this person doesn't know what they did. Maybe they did it in the dark, but God saw it. The angels saw it. There's divine judgment on them. They are a High Priestess. This person is spiritual. This person may act like they're not, but they are. They are a High Priestess, spiritual. And they did something here. The Ten of Swords is a betrayal, being backstabbed. Because this woman, this feminine energy here, male or female, this Princess of Pentacles, who is that Queen of Swords, did not ask for that, did not consent to that. Two of Pentacles and the Four of Cups. Two of Pentacles is juggling instability. Four of Cups. Yeah, this person is insecure, unstable, and they felt rejected and left out in the cold. So they did that to remind this feminine energy of them. It's almost like they felt rejected or they felt forgotten. So they did some sort of work to make this woman remember them. They did something to remind her of him. He did something to remind her of him. Wow, that is exactly what he did. This is spiritual work. There's a masculine energy here who is a spiritualist, but I always tell people, you have the light side of spirituality, you have the light versus the dark. This person, it was a betrayal, because it's like invading someone's, I don't know if this person tried to, I can't believe I'm picking up on this. This is the same energy. I don't like picking up on stuff like this, y'all. Because it's really an invasion of privacy. This could be the same energy. You guys know I talk very highly of Mystic Tori. She's one of my favorite readers. She picked up on something similar to this. And I think she called it like chakra. I don't know anything about the chakras. I'm going to be very, very honest. I need to learn more about it. But I feel like this has to do with a part of a story that she picked up on. It's very, because the feeling, like, it's upsetting me as well, because this is like an invasion of privacy. I don't know if they tried to get into someone's mind or enter someone's dream state. But the feeling, it just feels very invasive to do this to someone, which is why the Ten of Swords is here. It was a betrayal. This feminine energy did not consent to this. And Princess of Pentacles, like the Queen of Pentacles, these are very humble people. They're very successful, luxurious, but they're humble people. They did this, it's almost like they're like, I want to remind you of me. They were trying to remind this feminine energy about them. Like, even here on the back of the deck, And please discern that this message is not for everyone. If this message is for you, you know that someone tried to like tamper with you. And I don't feel like it worked because, again, the justice is in the upright. This, whoever this Princess of Pentacles, Queen of Swords is, this is someone who I feel is very protected. And many of the things that people do to them, it does not work. It doesn't work. The justice is in the upright. It didn't work. Balance and fairness was enforced here. It could have even backfired. If they were trying to tap into this person's mind or dream state, they probably ended up revealing some sort of secret about themselves to this feminine. Something here could have backfired. Yeah. Eight of Swords. This is all mental. This person was doing mental work, mental magic. I don't know what they call this. Eight of Swords. Being, someone feels completely invaded. I can feel their energy. And very sad and disappointed that this person would take it this far. The Eight of Swords is like being stuck in your head, being in a mental prison. So it backfired on this person here. Maybe now this person can't get out of their head. Maybe they're even experiencing some sort of psychosis. Something is like a boomerang. Whatever they try to tap into this person, but it backfired. Like something like a boomerang effect happened to this individual. And they probably got hurt, but now they're like, wait, if it backfired like this, I wonder if she's okay. Whoever I did this to, I wonder, that's why they're worried. They think that you're hurt. Clarify the Eight of Swords. But why would they think that you're hurt? Unless they're hurt. Unless it backfired on them, but they feel like something happened to you as well. Yeah, look, they're in the Two of Swords. Someone is, this person could be experiencing some sort of psychosis. They're in some sort of psychosis here because the Seven of Cups is like when you're in your head. So we had the Eight of Swords, mental prison, Two of Swords, feeling stuck, confused, under an illusion. Now we have the Seven of Cups in your head, thinking, making a decision. They may even be confused. Sometimes the Seven of Cups can represent confusion and illusions. And the Moon. Yeah, they're experiencing a psychosis. I don't know if that's the real word. I don't know if that's the real word, but the Moon card is here. This is something that can't be seen in the physical realm because it's most likely psychological or even spiritual. Wow. So now they're scared. They're worried that something may have happened to this feminine energy as well. That's why Five of Cups, they're regretful. The Wheel of Fortune. Whoever this feminine energy is, they're strong. Like they have justice here. Somebody has a justice card protecting them like this, you cannot cause them any injustice. It won't work. If anything, it'll backfire on you. It's like a karmic effect will happen to the person to the sender. Clarify this Wheel of Fortune. Let me see something here. Yeah, this person, the Wheel of Fortune talks about fate, destiny. It could talk about, you know, you either have good karma or bad karma. It just depends on what you did in the past. I kind of feel like this is someone things are moving forward for them. Whoever this feminine energy is, male or female, they're victorious. Six of Wands is victory. They won. Whatever this other psychological war, spiritual war was, they won it as well because it didn't hit them. It didn't affect them. It's almost like this may be this person's birthright, or it's just this like divine blessing that they have on their life where this person is like spiritually untouchable and most likely physically untouchable. The universe truly, truly favors this person and things will always go in their favor. Yeah, they get to move forward. Six of Swords, moving things from rough waters to calmer waters. Look, and they also have a Six of Pentacles. They're going to be compensated. Something here, Six of Pentacles is balance, equal give and take, reciprocity, wealth, abundance. Like, this is someone, like, this, I feel like their birthright is to be blessed. Their birthright is to be abundant. This person has inheritance to all that is good for them. So if anyone tries to block it or anyone tries to do something bad, it's not going to work. They attract, this person attracts all that is good for them. Yeah, look, judgment. That's the divine judgment upon their life. They attract and inherit all that is good for them. So if someone's sending something to them that is not good for them, it's not going to work. They have their birthright. They have inheritance to all that is good for them. So if they only attract what's good for them. So if you're sending something that isn't good, it's not going to work. The Hermit. I've never picked up on something like this before. The Hermit, the Hierophant. Yeah, this person, and look, King of Cups in the reverse. They're very like emotionally unstable, you know? They may even be kind of clingy, a little bit jealous. They don't strive to do right by people. King of Cups in the reverse is extremely emotionally manipulative. Whatever they try to do, they try to tap into this person mentally, maybe even their dream state, and to get this person to be reminded of them, or to get this person to, you know, go back to checking on them and wanting to reconnect with them. The Hermit is like healing, recovery, self-discovery. The Hermit, this could be God or a godly person, a religious figure, contracts, oaths, marriages. What is this Hermit and the Hierophant about? Two of Cups. The Lovers. This person wants to put you in some sort of contract with them. They want you to choose them. This person knows that you have a divine assignment. And they want to be the one that you choose. They want a seat at your table. The Two of Cups is a partnership. and the Lovers, two people who were brought together for a significant reason, or it's just a choice. And I feel like that's what it is. You get to choose who you want as a partner for your divine assignment or your purpose. And it's almost like, clarify the Hermit. Princess of Swords, this is you, Ten of Cups. If you agree to this contract with them, the two of you do get this happily ever after. But Pentacles. But the warfare was a lot between the two of you. The warfare was too much. Like you, it put the both of you in this Five of Pentacles, feeling left out in the cold, back-to-back hardships, misfortune, tragedies, you know, Seven of Wands. The two of you constantly had to defend yourself and stand your ground. The love was there. That Ten of Cups is unconditional love. The love was there. That true fulfillment was there. But it's like the constant war and battle and warfare was a lot. And I almost feel like you don't want it anymore. That's why you came. That's why this feminine energy is the Princess of Swords. She may not want it anymore. Ace of Cups. Ace of Cups is all about the new. The Magician. She's manifesting new love. Ace of Cups is new love, new offers, new opportunities. And the Magician is manifestation. And look, King of Wands. She could be manifesting a King of Wands to come in. Who is this? Who is this King of Wands? Someone who maybe is more equally yoked. This King of Wands is a Prince of Pentacles. So this King of Wands is like a warrior. They're strong, courageous, brave, ambitious, innovative, maybe even like an entrepreneur, a boss. You know, King of Wands is very attractive, sexy, assertive. He's also a Prince of Pentacles. He's also very successful, loyal, committed, traditional, grounded. Nine of Wands. This person has been through a lot as well. Nine of Wands is Wounded Warrior. Yeah, they've been through a lot. I feel like a lot of people have tried to... Wait, Princess of Cups. This King of Wands knows about this feminine, Three of Pentacles, whether they've met spiritually or physically, he knows about her. And I almost feel like with this Nine of Wands, he has been through some battles and challenges for her. He has fought for her. There's a Princess of Cups, or the two of them are about to meet each other. Look, Three of Pentacles, collaboration, recognizing something, studying something. He knows about this Princess of Cups. The two of them have not met physically. They've connected spiritually. What was that? Seven of Pentacles. Yeah, he has been manifesting her. He's been persistently pursuing. Yeah, look. Does he know her? Because there's a Princess. She's a Princess of Wands too. He's falling in love with her. The woman, the Princess of Cups, the woman who a man is in love with, Princess of Wands, he finds her to be loving, kind, genuine, compassionate. He finds her to be a Princess of Wands, very attractive. And look, Seven of Swords is here. Does he? If the two of them don't know each other, he knows about her. Or maybe the two of them know about each other. Or they're about to meet each other because the world is here. I feel like they're about to meet each other. I feel like, you know that saying, as one door closes, another door opens. If she chooses to close this cycle with this Prince of Swords, she gets a King of Wands in her new beginning. Look, she's even the Queen of Cups. Oh, she's gonna be into him, all right. Queen of Cups is very loving. Oh, the two of them are gonna hit it off. Oh, the two of them are gonna hit it off. Three of Wands. Teamwork. Waiting for an opportunity. I feel like this is teamwork. Perhaps the two of them have even been waiting. Yeah, the Hangman. Release, letting go, surrendering. Oh, the two, like when they meet, if they haven't already, they're just gonna go off together. Like, it's almost like I see them being in their own world and just ignoring everyone. The Three of Cups, celebrations, weddings, anniversaries. Oh, they're gonna hit it off. These two are gonna be like two peas in a pod. And he has been wanting a woman like this, whether he's been praying, manifesting her. So that's why this other man here, Prince of Swords, is like doing things to reach her, but he's trying to get her to not forget about him. He's tapping into her mentally, spiritually, something, her dreams, something. Nine of Pentacles. Success. Clarify this Nine of Pentacles. Clarify this Nine of Pentacles. King of Swords. He wants, I'm pretty sure this is him. Yeah, he wants success with her. But the Five of Swords is defeat. I don't feel like like I said, whatever he did didn't work. And she may not be interested in him anymore. Aw. Nine of Cups. Dang, he really wants her back. Nine of Pentacles, Nine of Cups. Like, he's looking at her like his dream woman, the one. But that Five of Swords, it is defeat. It is having to surrender. Yeah, the Tower. I feel like there's been a breakup. Maybe a breakup already happened and he just doesn't want to accept it because he's so passionate. He wants a passionate beginning. Let me see what happened here. I mean, why? What's going on with this man? The Strength is in the reverse. Strength in the reverse is not positive. In the upright, it's like overcoming difficulties and being courageous. This man may feel very weak and vulnerable, you know, lacking courage and bravery to come forward. What's going on with this man? Temperance, peace, balance, harmony. This temperance here. There's something that he's lacking. I feel like he's not happy. He's not in a state of peace. Queen of Wands. This man is sick. Like he's ill, like physically and spiritually. He feels like he's missing a part of him. Like a part of him is no longer there. And I feel like it's because this woman was a part of him. This Queen of Wands here, who he highly desires. The Temperance is like, maybe the both of them were like that yin and yang or something like that. He sees her as like his other half, and his other half is gone. So he's grieving, and he feels this is someone who is ill. And I hope they do get better. This is sad. Aw. Three of Swords, heartbreak. Y'all, the Three of Swords came back out again. Oh my gosh, he's hurt. Three of Swords, he is hurt. But this man is into, he's into magic. Queen of Pentacles. Clarify the Queen of Pentacles. Three of Pentacles. Three of Pentacles is like, Three of Pentacles is a collaboration. I feel like this woman though has a Ten of Pentacles. She has a choice between a Ten of Cups or a Ten of Pentacles. If she stays with this man, Ten of Cups, right? And they're both very valuable. If she goes to her new beginning and meets that King of Wands, she gets a Ten of Pentacles. It's going to be a life with this King of Wands is going to be much more stable, loyalty, commitment, security, success, generational wealth. That's where she's headed. And she's a Queen of Pentacles. This may be someone who's very successful as well, very grounded, you know, humble, loyal, commits to who she loves, who she loves and what she loves. There's some sort of communication that's here. She may even about to like encounter some people, like a team of people. She may work with someone to establish a Ten of Pentacles. Let's look at this Eight of Wands though. Yeah, Eight of Wands could represent communication or something that quickly happens. And I feel like that's what's going to happen. This Prince of Wands, I assure you, is that King of Wands. They're about to meet each other if they haven't already, and things are going to take off. They're going to work as a team, collaborate, and they're going to establish a Ten of Pentacles. Yeah. Ooh, and she's an Empress, or she's going to become an Empress. He may marry her. She may become the you know, his wife, the mother of his children. And look, Chariot. If this man, and then they're also going to get a Ten of Cups. So he's going to give her a Ten of Pentacles and a Ten of Cups. There's going to be a lot of like money, wealth, success, stability, security, but then there's also going to be true love, unconditional love, that happy home. That's what the Ten of Cups is, that happy home, happy family life. He's going to give her everything. Wow. Wow. If they haven't met each other already, when they do, this man is like, he's going to like scoop this woman up and just take her away. Like, he's going to make sure that she is all his. He's going to make her an empress, a wife, a mother, well-respected in the community, someone who's put on a pedestal. Wow. The Devil is here. Clarify the Devil. King of Pentacles. The Devil represents strong desires. He's not going to let this woman go. He may have already, I feel like this man, if they haven't met physically, like in the 3D, he has seen her spiritually. She was revealed to him, and I feel like he has fought for her. Like he was that Nine of Wands. He probably helped her with some of her spiritual warfare and stuff she was going through spiritually, praying for her. Like, this man strongly desires a woman like this. He wants to commit to her. He will commit to her. He's the King of Pentacles and she's the Queen of Pentacles. You see, between this past lover, this other man here, between the two of them, She was a princess of pentacles. Like, this is someone who is really valuable, but he was a prince of cups. He didn't have a pentacle for her. He only had a cup. He only had his love to offer her, feelings and emotions to offer her. But she's a princess of pentacles. She doesn't, yes, everyone needs love, but she also needs stability and security. And I feel like that's where he lacked. And I feel like that's when she became like a queen of swords, setting boundaries between the two of them. But I feel like he never stopped loving her. But then here you have another man who's like, I can give you everything. That 10 of cups that past man gave you, and a 10 of pentacles. And I'm going to make you an empress, my wife, the mother of my children, a highly respected woman, a woman of honor. King of Pentacles, like, he's ready. I actually feel like this man knows about this woman, whether spiritually or physically. And I feel like he has been working hard to protect her, but also to prepare a life for the both of them. He's like, even if they haven't met, when this man works, he's like, I need to work hard. You know, let me buy a home, or let me save up for the day that I do finally meet this woman. Wow. Yeah, she is his queen. She's the queen of cups. The woman who a man is in love with. She is the queen of cups. She has his heart already. He's worked hard. Eight of Pentacles is work, hard work that brings success. The both of them, have worked hard, and the both of them are unwilling to let her go. Like, two of swords is when you're at crossroads, you're stuck, you're not making a decision. Both of them are stuck on her. Both of them are like, I want this woman, especially this king of wands, and especially this prince of swords over here doing mental magic. Yeah, 10 of wands. They're not, this woman may be someone who's clearly, she's the star. She's extremely valuable, right? She's the star. But I feel like this is a woman who has faced a lot of warfare. And it's hard. It's hard to be with her. It's almost like maybe the enemy doesn't even want her to find a lover, to find a partner. So any man who wants her really has to fight for her. And perhaps both of them have. Who knows what this Prince of Swords went through to protect her, right? To fight for her. King of Wands has as well. He's faced some challenges, whether it's spiritually, physically, for her. This woman is literally like the prize. Like, you have to work hard first to get her, though. She's the star. She's chosen. Divinely chosen. I feel like both of these men have worked their butts off to get a chance with this Queen of Cups. Physically and spiritually. Let me see if we can pull out some advice for her. Seven of Pentacles. Yeah, they have. Seven of Pentacles is when you persistently pursue something or someone. The both of them have. Maybe one of them was fighting for her physically. The other one was fighting for her spiritually. Or both. Wow, she is the star. Let me see if I can pull out advice. Seven of Swords. What is this Seven of Swords about? Let me use the other deck. Let me see the Sun. I feel like it's being revealed how both of these men have been passionately pursuing her. That both of them are this Ace of Wands. They want a passionate beginning with her. They've been doing it in a sneaky way, though. The both of them have been pursuing her, but in a way where she didn't know. But now it's coming out. It's being illuminated with the Sun. She's becoming enlightened to how these men have been pursuing her. Seven of Swords, they were doing it in a sneaky way. They were doing it behind the scenes. Yeah, look. Seven of Wands. Seven of Wands sort of came out, so I just pulled it out. Seven of Wands, it's like standing your ground, protecting, defending. Yeah, they've worked. Both of them have worked hard to get success with her. Both of them. Both of them, as this is a woman where something where the enemy does not want her to meet her lover, to get in a partnership. So if you try to go towards her, you'll face some sort of warfare. But both of these men are like, I will die for this woman. No matter how burdensome it got, how heavy it got, they still chose to pursue her. This may be a woman who has a powerful destiny, and she needs her rightful partner, and that's why the devil does not want her to meet a strong man that will help her fulfill her purpose. So every man that goes towards her, he faces some sort of attack as well. Wow. Eight of Wands. This is gonna end though. The attacks, yeah, it's gonna end. Someone like tried to give a message to this woman. This man tried to give a message to this woman, but like mentally, like tapped into her mental state or her dream state. I don't know the right words, please excuse me, but look, Nine of Swords. It's almost like he tried to relay some sort of information to her, but mentally, yeah, so that the both of them can work together. Two of Wands, teamwork. Six of Pentacles, that equal give and take, you know? That's what the message was about. I don't know if she received it, if it was interpreted that way. But why do this? I wonder if he has tried to talk to her and she just rejected him, or if he's not talking to her, like, you know, because people don't read minds. Like, you need to come forward. Page of Wands. Yeah, this is some sort of communication here. Maybe he did try to talk to her, because Page of Wands is communication. Oh, but then there was a fight. Five of Wands. Did he try to talk to her? Because the Five of Wands is chaos and conflict. Let me see something here. Knight of Wands. King of Pentacles. He could have given a message to someone. I don't feel like there was any direct communication. I actually feel like when he tried to communicate, he could have gotten caught. He could have gotten caught trying to communicate. This man could even be committed to someone else. I'm not gonna lie. Seven of Swords. It's a big, like, liar, cheater, manipulator. And he's here as a King of Pentacles. He may be committed to someone else. And when he tried to communicate with her, I feel like he got caught. That's what I'm feeling here. The High Priestess. Someone who's secretive. This man is watched all the time. I don't feel like this man can talk the way he wants to, because I almost feel like he's being watched all the time. High Priestess is secretive, but the High Priestess is all-knowing. High Priestess is like mysterious. It's almost like he's being spiritually watched, even. this is King of Cups. Hold on. Who is this King of Cups? He's being watched by someone. King of Cups, male or female? Six of Cups, the past? Look, this is like a friend or something with a Three of Cups. This is someone who he's socially connected to, who may be watching him and trying to make it hard for him to connect with the woman who he loves. Like, there's some funny business going on here. Someone is being a traitor. This King of Cups presents himself to be very, like, compassionate, like he cares about people, and I feel like this is a friend who this man confides in. But look, the Tower is here. Something happened, something was exposed, maybe their friendship ended. I feel like he could have tried to block this man. Why did he do this? They're not friends anymore. Eight of Cups, walking away. Why did he do this? He had to leave. I feel like this Prince of Swords found out what he was doing. Why did he do this? It's almost like, yeah, this man, I don't know if he's with like a karmic or something, but they watch him. He's watched a lot. Nine of Wands, Wounded Warrior. This is sad. I don't know what situation this man is in, but I see he's watched. His every move is watched. And I feel like he may have been confiding in the wrong people who were also trying to block him from communicating with this his Princess of Pentacles. And that's just karmic with the Wheel of Fortune. It's a karmic wheel. It's a karmic lesson that he is failing to learn. Most likely stop letting outsiders intervene. Stop confiding in outsiders. Stop confiding in the wrong people. Confiding in people too quickly. It's like a never-ending karmic cycle that he will not learn. Maybe it was a third party that even broke them up or caused the breakup. He's not learning a karmic lesson. And until he does, he will not get out of this karmic cycle. And I feel like the karmic lesson is him always using third parties or outsiders to help him. It's like something here about not allowing third parties to intervene. There was a King of Cups who presented himself to be a good friend, someone who he could confide in. And this King of Cups was betraying him. King of Cups could have even been interested in this Princess of Pentacles as well. And that's why he did that. Something here, something about a betrayal from someone who he confided in, but it's a karmic lesson. He's not learning it and he needs to. Any guidance for this feminine energy? I feel like this feminine energy just needs to move forward, continue to move forward, protect herself, do prayers, continue her prayers and meditation. Yeah, the Empress, she is the divine feminine, and she's also a magician. This is a powerful woman here. No wonder that mental magic didn't work whatever they're trying to do, this is someone who is a magician as well. This is a big manifester. This is someone who's very powerful, especially spiritually and energetically. They are the Empress. This could be the energy of a divine feminine or someone who... The Empress is the most powerful woman in the deck. Loving, kind, nurturing, wise, abundant. She's a magician because she gives birth to things. She brings things to life. This is a very powerful person. Yeah. This is a magician because she has all the tools to manifest what she wants. The universe works with her. Everything flows with her. Wow. Yeah, I'm gonna end the reading there, okay? So thank you guys so much for tuning in. I really hope that this message helps. I hope it gives you some clarity, some guidance, and confirmation. You are loved, you are blessed, and you are divinely protected. Thank you guys so much. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to support the channel. If you're interested in connecting with me, definitely check out the description box. All my information is there, okay? Thank you guys. Take care.